Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, or welcome back if you have watched any of my videos before. So if you haven't, I'm a pet portrait artist and I do commissions of people's pets in coloured pencils. So this is just a drawing that I'm currently working on, and I just thought, you know what, why don't I do another draw with me video while I'm just drawing. So I've set my camera up and now I'm just gonna film while I draw. It's not gonna be like a tutorial or anything like that, just me carrying on with this drawing of Darcy. She's half Doberman, half Rottweiler, so. I did draw Jade, who is her daughter, her puppy, a few months ago, so now I'm just doing Darcy. So yeah, I'm just working on the lovely orange part of her fur at the minute. I used a Faber-Castell polychromos in cream as a base, and now I'm just using burnt ochre on top to start building up the orangey fur, and I'm pressing on very lightly with the coloured pencils. I press quite hard with the base and then press lightly with whatever I'm layering on top, and I've been doing that a lot more recently and I've found it just comes out looking a bit nicer. I used to press on so hard with everything, every layer, and if you make a mistake, it's a lot harder to correct it, and it's just, I don't know, I just think it looks a bit softer, a bit more, I don't know what it is, but I just like the look of it. And it doesn't hurt my hand as much because I have like a big red lump on my finger. And now that I'm doing this full time, I don't want to make that any worse than it already is. So it's a lot less pressure on my hand, and it, I think overall, it looks nicer. But that's just my personal opinion. Obviously everyone has completely different styles and different ways of drawing. There's a few artists that I follow that have quite like a strong, sort of like, you can tell they use a heavy hand and it looks amazing, but I think naturally I'm just better at doing a softer sort of drawing. But I love that everyone has like their own distinct style. Like, even the pictures of when people follow my tutorials, they all look so different, and like everyone's got their own style. Even when following a video that's telling you step by step what to do, and I love that. I love that you can put your own slant on everything. So I'm just gonna carry on building up this fur. Oh, it's so hot again today. It's the 7th of September and it's like it's the middle of July again. I love hot weather when you're like out and you're like at the beach or chilling in the garden or something. I feel like our homes in Britain are not kitted up for this weather. It's so hot in my office. Need aircon. I actually had my heater on yesterday. And now it's like hottest day of the year again. I'm just using cold grey one now to just make this, extend this bit. Sort of trying to like blend the cold grey into the cream so it's seamless. and I'm going to use cold grey 5. And I've got some new pencil extenders, so that's good. Now I can actually use all my tiny pencils. I got these off Amazon and they were like £3 or something, and they come in loads of different colours. I've got like five or six of them for a few pounds, so I will link them below if anyone's interested. It does make it a lot easier when you've got a tiny pencil. And I've been using Payne's Grey on top as like a top layer of detail on the black fur. It's like a really nice like bluey tone. It's hard because this portrait will be displayed with the other portrait of Jade, like side by side. And I feel like I draw a bit different now to when I drew that one. But I need to make this look like it's consistent with the other, if that makes sense. Like the colours and how intense the colours are and stuff. It needs to look uniform with the other one. So I keep looking back at pictures of it and making sure that it's looking similar, because they are the same colour in real life as well, the dogs. I actually took this picture myself as well, so you can get a really good reference picture just by using an iPhone or something. As long as you've got like really good lighting. As long as the dog can stay still for long enough. I'm using burnt umber now just to add a bit of detail. Sort of on the edge of this orange bit, because a bit more browny around here. I've had some really nice feedback on the how I scan my artwork video, so thank you to everyone that watched that and said it was helpful. I'm glad it was useful. I'll be doing the greeting cards video soon. Ended up just tweaking a bit of the drawing and rescanning it, so I will get on that soon. It was actually really hard to do the last bit of that drawing because the picture I had, you couldn't see one of the feet, so I kind of had to use different pictures and make it up a bit, which was really hard. I'm not very good at doing that. Like, I have so much respect for artists that can just make stuff up and don't even draw from a picture, they just draw from the head. I just don't understand how people do that. I think I'm one of them people that doesn't have a photographic memory or can't see pictures in the head. Which is a bit silly considering I draw for a living, but I just can't visualise stuff in my head. Is anyone else like that? Like people that can just look at something and then draw it after seeing it for the first time and not using a picture.
can't get my head around it.
I wish I could do that.
I'm just using black now.
I've been listening to audiobooks recently while I've been drawing. That's been nice. Just listened to The Daughter-in-Law, which is like a thriller novel. And that was really good. I did like that. I think sometimes I get a bit bored of listening to music while I'm drawing. It's just good to mix it up a bit. So if anyone's got any book recommendations or anything to listen to, I need something new to start now. I love drawing short-haired dogs. Especially like black coloured dogs. It's so nice to like get all the details. I've been using a bit of light cobalt turquoise like here and there as well, like up here, just to add a bit of an extra colour to add more of like a vibrancy. I think it works nice. Pressing like really lightly though, so it don't go crazy. I do this a lot with black fur. I think it just makes it look a bit shinier, a bit more like there's a glossy sort of finish to the fur. My laptop's making a loud noise.
I'm also filming a reel for this portrait, so I've been like filming a little bit at a time, and actually I have to keep reminding myself to film. Then I can do like the whole sort of like process from start to finish.
I do quite enjoy drawing without any music or anything on sometimes. It's quite relaxing.
Just like the sound of the pencils.
Thank you.
My door just opened on its own. look. missed it actually.
I'm just going to turn my paper. Right, I'm going to go and get a drink now, so I'll leave it at that just for this video. And if you want to follow more progress on this portrait, then follow me on Facebook or Instagram. I'll post updates and photos of where I'm up to. And if you have enjoyed this draw with me video, please like the video and subscribe, and I will film more. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed it. It's only been a short one. And have a good rest of your day. I'll see you later.